Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. Whew. It's been a few years, I think, since the last time I recorded anything. It's been busy. How are you? How's it been going? Great, great. So it's been a crazy year, and now we're into a new year. Hopefully things will get better. A lot of things have been going on with me, but we'll get into that with time. So what you're looking at right here is a little video game that I've been creating, not like as a serious thing, but you know, I've been working on my art style, and I thought it'd be cool to work on coding and stuff. So I've been making this was my first attempt at a video game. I actually did basically the same game, a little bit bigger, in RPG Maker, just fooling around figuring out that program. But let's go ahead and well, first, let's see if I can't remember how to make it play. There we go. Just hit the wrong buttons. Yeah. Okay, so my opening thing is a little too big. Oh, is it going to capture? Oh, wait, one sec. It's not going to capture the right thing. There we go. Oh, crap. But I didn't. Eh, one sec. I want. Wait. I don't think that was the opening. Okay, I think we're fine. Okay. It's been so long since I've had to do any of this. Let me move this if I can. Okay, hopefully that didn't mess with my capture. Okay, so, yeah, obviously, I did all the art myself, and I think it turned out really good. But anyways, so, even, this is so old school, I even have to program in, like, new game, load game, all of that, so that was interesting. Start a new game, want to start a new adventure? If you say no, oh, I think I got rid of that. It used to be sassy. It was like, well, fine then. or maybe that's in the RPG Maker. I can't remember. Okay, so new game, want to start a new adventure? Yes. Okay, even the saving mechanic, as far as I recall, was a little tricky. So, as far as anyone can remember, the Dragoon Tower has always existed. However, this is where sound effects would play, but I don't have any. As archaeologists, probably spelled that wrong, have recently discovered from ancient stone tablets worn away by time. Long before the thriving city of Terra existed, there was the budding village of Terrazar. It is now believed that the first time the day turned darker than night. Oop, that was a bad transition. I need work on that. And lightning raged across the land. Was the day the Dragoon Tower appeared, destroying half of Terrazar, the first of many monster towers that had started popping up around the world. There's supposed to be a transition here or something. Uh-oh. Oh, no, when I was doing... I must have broke it last time I was doing stuff. Hold on one sec. I don't remember how to do any of this. Oh, no. Okay, I think I got it fixed. There we go. Look at my little guy I made. He's... Okay, so this is obviously, like, super old school stuff. Like, I only had, like, 4 colors, I think, to mess with. And so... just creating all the tiles and textures and all that. Like everything that you see, I had to hand make the coding and the everything. This is a really cool little program called GB Studio that I will link to if I can remember to do that. I actually haven't messed with this in over half a year. Look at his little hairy waggles when he walks. Do. I haven't actually messed with this world in like half a year. So just fixing that scene transition took me a little bit. But let's see here. A bunch of Dad's old books about the Dragoon Tower. Want to read one? And you kind of learn a little bit from context clues. Like, oh, what's going on over here? What's this? What's this right here? Hope you're resting well. I love you, Mom. Aw, no, your mom is dead. Aw, your mom is dead, and your dad's probably also dead. Actually, he's not dead, but you don't know that yet. And look at this. doo-doo-doo, off in the distance, there's the Dragoon Tower and there's the town. It's so limiting what you can do, which really brings out the creativity in the game. And here's one of my... this took me a while. This eventually would have been a random encounter spot for monsters. But I'm really proud of this. Watch this, watch this. Doing! It does a little front flip off the ledge. Let's watch that again. There we go. Okay, I think, wait, did I ever set run? No, I didn't program in run yet. Okay. Boink! I think that's so cool. And it just felt really cool that, like, you know, I did all this myself. And, you know, each spot has to be self-programmed in. Boink! And you have to program in, like, when character reaches this spot and presses down, then play this animation on this spot, and then move actor to this spot so it appears as if he's seamlessly just gone boink to this spot here. But yeah, so I haven't gotten too awful far. I think this is as far as you can go in the map. Yeah, so this was a lot of work. I was working on a lot of tile sets and such. Been working on my art, but let me show you what I've been doing in RPG Maker. All right, one sec. Transition into a freaking empty page that you can't tell what the heck's going on. Okay, so anyways, yeah, spoilers. No looking around. Close your eyes. I'm going to hit play. Hopefully this captures that. I don't know if it's going to open a separate menu, just like the... Is it on the... Okay, I'm... Oh, crap, one sec. Okay, there we go. Okay, geez, there are so many menus and flipping around that I have to do. Okay, let's start a new game. This is all just default. But this is what I've done so far in RPG Maker. Okay, very dramatic, it's a scene. Hold on. Shh, shh, story time, shh. Sorry for the wait. Between the villagers and the monsters, I had my hands full.
I'm just glad you're safe. The babies do any day.
Still unable to do girl voices. There's no way I could raise a child all on my own. Hey, give yourself some credit. I fell in love with you because of how strong and fierce you are, not to mention your stunning beauty. By strong, do you mean how I totally kicked your ass? Oh, whoops. Well, this isn't the first minute of the video, I guess, so that's fine. As I recall, I totally got your ass handed to you. I'm sorry. My sense of humor clearly is coming out in my game. Relax, I'm just joking. Kinda. So, have you thought of a name for our baby yet? Well, I've given it lots of thought, actually. How about... And then you get to name your character, whatever you want. It doesn't matter. For this, well... Oh, crap. What were the buttons? I still have to work on that. Let's name him... let's just go with Phoenix, huh? Also, I need to get a quieter keyboard if I'm gonna make more videos, because I'm sure that's picking up. I like the clacking for when I'm playing, but for videos, it's not good. Okay. Whoops, what the heck? How did I do that? I thought there was a quick button just to go to, okay. Alright, I love it. Phoenix it is. Oh my god, this scene took me like 5 hours. Just figuring out how to make things work in this game. Obviously, I got way better with practice, but... Anyways, I like this whole scene, by the way. If I'm really going to make this game, this whole scene's gonna change because of the way I've programmed it. I used up a lot more resources, let's just say, than I had to. Anyways, so I have some bad news. Things are only getting worse at the tower. I don't know how much longer I can stay away. Wait, so you're going to have to return to the Dragoon Tower? Perhaps in time. But for now, though, I'll be right here with you and Phoenix. Seeing my child grow up is my drip.
Bedar! The village! It's being overrun! What? I thought we had just cleared out the last wave. We did, but they just keep coming! At this rate, the village is done for!
Ah, damn it! Alright, I'll be there soon. Go help who you can.
Right!
The whole dramatic scene. See, in this, there's a lot more talking and action. I didn't get to program that into the other version.
Wait, no, I thought we had time.
I did too.
But now, listen, I will never forgive myself for this. But if I don't go, it isn't just the village in danger. You and Phoenix are not far from the village. I understand, but I'm scared. Phoenix will never get to know how amazing their father is. I feel like some words need to be adjusted there. Oh, you're really kind, thoughtful. And your biggest weakness is strawberry snow cones. Spoilers, if I ever make this a real game, there's going to be an item that you can buy. Strawberry snow cones. And if you use that on the enemy, like, because spoilers again, the final boss is going to be your father. And if you use that on him, it'll be an instant KO. I just thought that'd be like a real like, ha, you paid attention. You'll never let me live that down, will you? Nope. I love you. I love you too. Now go, Mr. Hero. Protect us all. Right. Maybe this is how it should be. Oh, Baylor. Everyone should be able to have dreams. Silence. Alright. And so my whole thought process was like, because it's not programmed into the game yet, but, can I do anything in here? I forget. I think I can look at this journal. My dear son, I know how scary this must be for you. Things have been hard since your father left to save us from the Dragoon Tower. Oops, I've obviously messed up on my coloring there. But you and I always managed. You're a 12-year-old boy now, and while I wish I could watch you grow into a man, I'm afraid my illness won't let me do so. So before I go, I wanted to write this down so you won't ever forget. In Balber Village... Balber? I don't think I named it that, did I? I don't know. Again, there's a lot of things I gotta adjust. The people don't think kindly of your father. Balber? Where the heck did that come from? That's weird. They blame what happened 12 years ago on him. It's not my place to tell you why. Now I have one last thing to ask you, my lovely boy, before I no longer have the strength to hold a quill. You must grow up strong. Grow very strong. So in a few years, you can head off to the Dragoon Tower. Make your way to the very top. There you will learn the truth of what happened to your father. Also, don't forget, while people may treat you differently, you are sure to find good friends. Who knows? Maybe you'll even find a girlfriend. Phoenix, I love you. Dream big. It's been 4 years. Time to keep my promise. Don't worry, Mom. I'll make you proud. So she died when he was 8 years old. Even I didn't remember that little part. And then same as in the... Oh, you can... Wait. You can run in this one. There's her grave. Rest well. So that kind of gives you a lot more backstory than in the other version, obviously. And then, classic RPG style. It's like, oh, there's a sign here. What's this? Remember, monsters appear in tall grass, caves, and dungeons. And then you can run around. Ta-da! Check it out. So you get random encounters and such. Very RPG style. My whole plan was to completely replace. Hold on one sec. This is still very loud. How do I? There. I don't know if that's louder on the recording or not, or quieter or whatever. Hopefully it turns out good. Anyways, so it's a very RPG game, obviously, because my inspiration came from Azure Dreams. This game. I really liked that game, so there was going to be monster catching and taming, and lots of, let's see if I can, another encounter, 1 second. Enemies in this area are a little tougher, and I do not have the run ability yet, or rather I didn't program it in. Oh, he didn't attack. And there's a lot of adjustments and stuff you gotta do to balance things out well. This is a tougher enemy. You're not supposed to come into this area until you leveled up, like one time at least, I think. So I'm probably not even gonna be able to make it. Normally I start this off like at level 3 so I can get all the way to the event. Not that it matters, but you run into a new companion. And again, I haven't worked on this one for like 4 months. But you run into a companion, she's really funny, and then she introduces you to her dad, and then you join together, and you start going through the Dragoon Tower eventually. I don't have that in the game yet. That slime that you saw originally in the Game Boy version, I wanted to have him as kind of like a main, like a mascot, like Pikachu kind of is for Pokemon, you know? And you're supposed to be able to date people and build up the city
and do all sorts of side quests, and there'd be this cool mechanic where, like, time does pass, and every once in a while monsters will escape from the tower and start creating havoc through the town. And then depending on, like, if you complete the quest or not, you save part of the town, and there's consequences for things to do, and they're just ideas I was throwing around, but I thought that was really cool. But anyways, I just want to say to all of you guys, wait, hold on, let me get to a quieter area first, or actually let's just, okay. I know I haven't been making videos or anything, and yet, despite that, I still got more subscribers, and I mean, that alone was interesting. I think that was a lot because of a couple of my series. But there's a, I know there's a handful of you that have been very dedicated, just waiting for me to post a new video. And I doubt this video is even going to turn out very well, because this was just very much like me slamming crap together and just showing you kind of some stuff I've been doing. Like, I started doing karate about a year ago, and I think in the next month or two I'll be a brown belt. And to anybody who does karate, you're probably thinking to yourself, dude, you're probably not going to a good school then, because that's really fast. And it is. Well, like, the average is 18 months to become up the first, or third degree brown belt. And I'm about on track with that, even though I did take like 6 months off or something. It was a good stretch of time because of COVID. And that's because the school I'm going to is actually, it's a really good school. I got a really good teacher. And I don't, like, again, if you're in, if you know anything about karate, you know that Ed Parker was the original founder of American Kenpo. And underneath him, there was a guy named Jim Mitchell. And Jim was actually like a really good student of Ed Parker's. And he's actually in some of his books. Like, he's the guy they used for modeling pictures and stuff. And then Jim Mitchell went around and learned more than what he could get from Ed Parker, and then made up his kind of own style, and made it, he made his own list, basically. Like, when you're learning karate, the moves are all over the place, and so then you've got to learn this, like, long forms and short forms and stuff, and it's a little trickier because it's like there'll be moves in the form that aren't even in the list that you're learning at the time. It's later on. And so Jim Mitchell went ahead and organized it so it's a lot easier and faster to learn. And he taught his son, Gerald Mitchell, who is teaching me. He's a real cool guy. And so, yeah, I've been learning karate. And let's see what else. I took a good 8 months off because of COVID. That was fun. Played a lot of Elder Scrolls Online. Like, a lot. Yeah. Good game. I like it. Way better than their Fallout 76 game, that's for sure. That was not very good. I played a decent chunk of that. It's a lot better than when it first came out, but yeah, that game, not meant to be an MMO, for sure. And, you know, just gaming here and there, karate, making video games, doing some art. Here's the thing I'm thinking about doing. I'm thinking about creating for myself a, because I got a webcam. I'm thinking about setting it up so that you guys can see me, and I'll be a virtual YouTuber. I don't know. You tell me what you think about that. I think it'd be kind of cool. Because I don't really, I'm not 100% comfortable showing my face, and I think that'd be a great way to still get, like, my reactions and face on film or camera without really showing me, not to mention I have, like, $1,000 worth of camping gear poking out of closet right behind me. So even if I did just show my face, I'm going to need to buy some kind of screen, whether green screen or I think like a cool bamboo painted Japanese type screen would be cool as a background. I don't know, but something to hide that because it's kind of a nice wear that. And I have my training equipment in this room as well. So it's just a bunch of workout equipment. But anyway, so that's been it for me. If you guys want to see me play video games, I've been kind of out of the YouTube loop a little bit. You know, I mean, I'm watching my own YouTube, but I don't really know what's all popular on YouTube anymore for gaming since it's such a big space. So if you guys want me to play any games, feel free to give me suggestions in the comments below. But as well, if you guys want to add me on Steam, I'm at Phoenix2Blade. That's just the word Phoenix and the number 2 and Blade. No upper caps, all lower, and all one word basically. No spaces. And you guys can just send me a game if you want, and I'll give that a shot. Or you can check out what's on my wish list, and I'll gladly play those. And we'll make a fun little series. We'll make a comeback. That's what we'll do. We'll, you know, because I got 800 subscribers, but what I'm thinking is, well, like, out of the 800, how many are really going to come back? I doubt very many. So we'll basically, we'll have to get a couple thousand more subscribers that actually do come to the show, you know, that actually watch. And we'll make a comeback. What do you guys think? Up to you. But anyways, that's what's been going on with me. You know, I'd love to hear about how you guys are doing. See if you're, you know, how's school been? You know, how's life? Let me know. And as they say nowadays, don't forget to hit that like. Don't forget to smash that like button. What was it? I just watched, I think it was Netflix special where they were talking about 2020 and the Queen of England. She's doing her formal speech and at the end she's like, and don't forget to smash that like button. Is that what it's come to nowadays? But anyways, thank you very much for watching. And you know what? It's good to be back. Big shot, so what do you wanna?